I don't think we're telling enough stories around how AI can be used for good and how AI is being used in places outside of America and Europe. But also thinking about how we may continue to build an ecosystem that encourages and celebrates open sharing and open innovation. My name is Angela Oduor Lungati. I'm the Executive Director of Ushahidi. I like to describe myself as a human bridge because a lot of my work over the last few years has been trying to bridge the gap between people building technology and those who are using it to ensure that there's value across that chain. Now in my role as Executive Director, I'm thinking about the technology that we build and how it fits into the bigger picture of what kind of impact we want to create in the world. Ushahidi is a global nonprofit technology company born out of post-election violence in Kenya back in 2007, 2008. It's actually why the company is called Ushahidi, because that's a Swahili word that means testimony. A lot of what was going on in the country at the time was either underreported or not reported at all. And the founders set up this open source platform that made it easy for people to send in texts or emails or tweets about what was going on around them. And then it would get aggregated and visualized on a map. And so we've spent a lot of time helping people to quickly gather data, but we're also thinking about how we then help them generate insights from that data to then drive the change that we are looking for. And that's led to the platform being used in more than 160 countries.
This app is literally changing the world.
And this is where artificial intelligence comes in, because it presents a unique opportunity in terms of driving the speed of how we're able to generate insights. The last 2 months, we've had sustained protests in Kenya. Ushahidi has been doing social listening during this time, trying to really meet people where they are to discover what exactly they've been speaking about, what their sentiments are like. And so it's been primarily data from social media. And in a span of 2 months, I think we've collected more than 2 million tweets. Now, without AI, trying to structure the data, that would probably have taken us thousands of volunteers, probably would have taken us weeks. But because we have these prototype AI models that we developed, we've been able to reduce the amount of time into just a number of hours. You know, it's really helped us to see the value in being able to apply AI to reduce that time lag. And the kinds of outputs we've been able to generate have been so powerful. Now it's really helping us to move beyond what, you know, collecting the data into what are some of the insights that we're able to share around what the protests might mean and how we need to show up better. And so right now our focus is on how we can make this accessible to every single person who makes use of the Ushahidi platform. I'm honored to be recognized as a Rise25 honoree, and I hope that it can continue to create awareness around how AI can be used for good in spaces outside of the typical spaces that we know of. Technology is really useful and can be a really good enabler in creating social impact, but it is just that, an enabler. It's in the same way that I look at artificial intelligence, a means to help people tell better stories with the data that they're collecting, a means for them to generate better insights that they're able to shape the world that they want to see.